Transverse resonance technique. We have already studied the analysis of closed waveguides like rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. And in these waveguides, we start with solving Helmholtz wave equation for the longitudinal field component. And from solving this longitudinal wave equation, we obtain solution for the longitudinal field component with some unknowns. And by solving the boundary conditions, or by applying the boundary conditions, we could obtain these unknowns. And one of these unknowns is the cutoff wave number, Kc. In this technique, transverse resonance technique, we are going to represent a simpler way to obtain directly the cutoff wave number, Kc. Maybe we are not planning to obtain the field distribution, but we are planning to obtain the cutoff frequency. And if we know the cutoff frequency, it is supposed that we can obtain the propagation constant beta, because beta is the square root of k squared minus kc squared. So, transverse resonance technique represents a simple technique to obtain the cutoff wave number of complicated waveguides without the need to solve all the wave equation or all Maxwell's equation. We say that if we know the cutoff wave number Kc, we can determine the propagation constant of the waveguide. The main idea of the transverse resonance technique is that we are going to convert the transverse geometry of the waveguide section as a transmission line model. So, if we are talking, for example, about a rectangular waveguide, the rectangular waveguide, the longitudinal direction is the z direction, and the transverse plane is the xy plane. So, the xy plane can be represented in the direction of x or the direction of y as transmission line sections in the direction of x or the direction of y. So, the transverse resonance technique employs a transmission line model of the transverse cross-section of the waveguide and gives much simpler and more direct solution for the cutoff frequency. Actually, it is used only to obtain the cutoff frequency, not the field distribution. The transverse resonance procedure is based on the fact that in a waveguide at cutoff, the field form standing waves in the transverse plane of the guide. If we remember the barrel plate waveguide, in the barrel plate waveguide, we said that the transverse electric or transverse magnetic mode, they can be represented as a multiple reflected waves with an angle theta. At the cutoff frequency, this angle theta is 90 degrees. It means that as the wave is multiple reflected directly between the two conductor plane across the cross section of the transverse plane. That's what we are seeing, that the field form standing wave in the transverse plane of the waveguide. So, at the cutoff frequency, the wave represents a standing wave in the transverse plane. And this transverse plane is represented as a transmission line model. So we are talking about a resonant circuit in the transmission line model which correspond to this transverse plate. So we are looking for the frequency which correspond to the resonance of the transmission line model of the transverse plane of the waveguide. This situation can be modeled with an equivalent transmission line circuit operating at resonance. I am sure that this slide is not quite clear now, but if you are looking in the following example, the next slide, it will be clear. Not this slide, this slide. This slide corresponds to a partially filled rectangular waveguide. In this partially filled rectangular waveguide, we have dielectric layer of thickness T and an air layer of thickness B minus T. We have solved a similar problem, but it was in the longitudinal direction such that it was in x from 0 to T and from T to A. And when we solved partial filled waveguide, we solved it by using full wave analysis and by using boundary condition and so on. Effectively, this problem from the transverse plane can be represented as a transmission line section short circuit here and another transmission line section short circuit here connected to each other. And it is required to obtain the resonant frequency of two short circuit transmission line sections which are connected in parallel, assuming that these are the two nodes, this transmission line and this another transmission line, and this node 1 and node 2. So they are two parallel short circuit transmission line section. What is the resonance of this transmission line section? That's what we are calling transverse resonance technique. Transverse because we are talking about the transverse plane of the cross section of the waveguide. Resonance because we are looking for the resonance behavior of this circuit or equivalent circuit. Okay? Let us go back to this slide, but before we should study here. Transverse resonant technique, one of the conditions of such a resonant line is the fact that at any point of the line of this equivalent line circuit, the sum of the input impedance seeking looking into either side must be zero. For example, here we have a transmission line in the upper side, and here we have an equivalent transmission line at the lower side. This can be, if we are talking about partially filled waveguide in x direction, one in the right and one in the left. So maybe one the upper and one in the down, one the right or one in the left. So in this case, we have an input impedance in this direction and another input impedance in this direction. So that's what we are seeing. At the resonance, Z input to the right direction in X plus Z input to the left, right, to the left side in X, the summation of the two impedance at the resonance should equal zero. Actually, this reminds us with the resonant circuit of LC circuit. In parallel LC circuit, the input impedance of L plus the input impedance of C should equal zero, where ZR and ZL are the input impedance seen looking to the right side and to the left side respectively at any point X on the resonant line. As I mentioned, the transverse resonant technique only gives us results for the cutoff frequency of the waveguide. So, all what we will see or what would we get from the transverse resonance technique is the cutoff frequency. And from the cutoff frequency, we can obtain the propagation constant as beta equals square root k squared minus kc squared. Now let us apply the transverse resonance technique for the case of partially filled rectangular waveguide. And this partially filled, as I mentioned, it is filled with a substrate of thickness t in y direction, and the remaining part is air. And it assumes that we are interested in transverse electric zero n mode. Why we are interested in transverse electric zero n mode? Transverse electric zero n mode has electric field in the transverse plane which is constant along the x, such that it has no variation in x direction, zero variation in x direction, it is constant in x, and has any variations in y. So the electric field in this case is parallel to the interface of the dielectric medium. Means that the electric field in this case, if we are looking for this structure as a transmission line section, it would be transmission parallel plate transmission line section short circuit, and here another parallel plate transmission line section short circuit. The difference between this transmission line section and this transmission line section is that the dielectric material here is air, so the dielectric constant is epsilon naught, while the dielectric material here has a relative permittivity epsilon r, so the dielectric constant is epsilon r epsilon. For the case of transverse electric modes, the transverse field components are given by hx equal minus j beta over kc squared partial hz by partial x, hy equals minus partial beta by over kc squared partial hz by partial y, ex equal minus j omega mu over kc squared partial hz by partial y, Ey equals g omega mu over kc squared partial hz by partial x. Actually, I'm not planning to use these equations. If I'm planning to use these equations, this means that I'm solving the wave equation. This is not the transverse resonance technique. But this is just a reminder to obtain what we are talking about is what is the characteristic impedance of the equivalent transmission line. Okay? Alright, where kx squared plus ky squared equals kc squared, and we are talking about transverse electric zero n mode. Zero n mode, it means that the value of kx is zero. This means that kc squared equals ky squared. And in this case, the derivative with respect to x, which correspond to kx, would be zero. So the element hx and the element ey are zero. So the transverse field components in the case of transverse electric zero n mode are ex, which is in this direction, and hy, which is in this direction. And Ex is proportional to the derivative of Hz with respect to Y, which is proportional to Ky. And here Kc equals Ky. So here we have Ky over Ky squared. So this would correspond to minus J omega over Ky, Hz. In a similar way, This is minus j beta over k y of h z. This means that the ratio of ex to hz, ex, the ratio of ex to hz, the ratio of ex to hz is proportional to omega mu ky over kc squared, so which can be written ky and kc squared is ky, so this 1 over ky, omega mu it can be represented as k eta, k omega square root mu epsilon, and eta square root of mu over epsilon, so k eta equals omega mu. This means that the value of ex over hz, the value of ex over hz equals k eta over ky. This actually is the impedance or the wave impedance for the transverse electric field component with respect to the longitudinal magnetic field component. Should be noted here, I'm not talking about the wave impedance of the transverse electric mode. The wave impedance of transverse electric mode is Ex over Hy, which is K eta over beta. But here, I'm talking about K eta over Ky. K eta over Ky is the wave impedance of the transverse field component compared to the longitudinal magnetic field component. Right? The conventional wave impedance for the TE mode, it was the transverse electric field component to the transverse magnetic field component. And this was K eta or omega mu over beta. But in the present case, it is omega mu over Ky. Alright? Okay, now assuming that these are two plates, we have electric field in Ex and magnetic field in Hz. This actually the transverse electromagnetic mode of parallel plate waveguide. This means that I'm talking about a transmission line which correspond to transverse electromagnetic mode with a characteristic impedance equal k eta over ky. So these two parallel plates in the direction of y corresponds to a parallel plate waveguide with a characteristic impedance equals k eta over ky. The question now is which k and which eta. If I am in the free space, it would be k naught and eta naught. If I am in the dielectric medium, it would be k1 eta1. So this transverse cross section can be represented as two transmission line sections. One short circuit transmission line section here corresponds to the upper half, and a lower short circuit transmission line section here corresponds to the lower half. And the characteristic impedance here is ZA, which corresponds to ZR, and ZR equals K naught, eta naught, over KY at the air, the propagation constant at the air. And the characteristic impedance of the lower transmission line would be Z dielectric, ZD, which equals K eta over KY dielectric. And K eta with equal k1 eta 1. K1 equal omega square root mu naught epsilon naught epsilon r. And eta 1 equal square root of mu naught over epsilon naught epsilon r. Here we have a square root of epsilon r in the numerator and square root epsilon r in the denominator. So k eta, the multiplication of k eta, equals the multiplication of k naught eta naught. Because here we are in non-magnetic material, k eta equals omega mu, and because we are talking about non-magnetic material, k eta equals k naught eta naught. But kyd is not the same. Okay, kyd is the transverse propagation constant in the dielectric slab, where k naught equals omega square root mu naught epsilon naught, eta naught equals square root mu naught over epsilon. So the equivalent circuit for this cross section is two short circuit transmission line sections, one for the upper section and one for the lower section. Now to apply the transverse resonance technique, we are going to say that, assuming that I am in this plane, input impedance to the upper plus input impedance to the lower would correspond to the total input impedance at this plane. Input impedance to the upper, this is short circuit transmission line. And from the transmission line theory, we know that the short circuit transmission line, the input impedance for the upper would be J Z naught, which is ZA here, tan beta multiplied by the length of the transmission line. Beta here is the propagation constant, KY air. And the length here, assuming that this is B and this is T, so this is B minus T. On the other hand, the input impedance looking down is JZ naught, Z naught here is ZD, tan beta, beta here is KYD, multiplied by the length of the transmission line section, which is T in this case. So this is the input impedance looking to the upper side, and this is the input impedance looking to the downside. At the resonance, the total input impedance, Z input up plus Z input down, should be zero. So the resonance or the resonant equation is J ZA tan KYA beta minus T plus J ZD tan KYD multiplied by T equals zero. And actually, ZA is k naught eta naught over kya, and zd equals k naught eta naught over kyd. So we are going to apply this k naught eta naught over kya and this k naught eta naught over kyd and make the summation, and the summation would be zero, so we can eliminate J, we can eliminate K naught eta naught. This would be 1 over KYA multiplied by 10 KYA plus 1 over KYD multiplied by 10 KYD. If we are multiplying both sides by KYA, KYD, it would be KYA 10 KYD multiplied by T, which is the second term, plus KYD multiplied by 10 KYA multiplied by B minus T would be 0. Actually, this is the characteristic equation of the transverse resonance in this case. This is function of KYA and KYD. Actually, there is another relation which governs the relation between KYA and KYD, which is that the propagation constant beta is the same for the upper layer and the lower layer, and beta equals the square root epsilon r k naught squared minus kyd squared in the dielectric layer, and equals the square root k naught squared minus ky air squared at the air layer. So this value equals this value, which can be represented as epsilon r k naught squared minus kyd squared equals k naught squared minus kya squared, or in other words, we can take this kyd squared in this side. So kyd squared minus kya squared equals epsilon r minus 1 k naught squared. So we have now two relations between kya and kyd, and these two nonlinear relations can be solved simultaneously, as we have solved before for the case of surface wave modes, to obtain the value of kya and kyd. And once we obtain kya and kyd, we obtain the propagation constant beta of this mode. So now it is only required to solve these two equations to obtain the propagation constant of the partially filled waveguide without the need to solve all the field components. So these two equations can be solved numerically or graphically to obtain kyd and kya. Actually, there is infinite number of solutions which correspond to the n modes or independence or number of variation which correspond to TE0N modes. Alright. Actually, transverse resonance technique is very useful for solving the propagation constant for many complicated waveguides. Alright.